I'm John Whyte. I'm a physiatrist and an experimental psychologist, and I'm the director of the Moss Rehabilitation Research Institute. The FIM, as probably most people know, is a measure of functional independence. It looks at primarily self-care activities, mobility, and cognition. It was really designed for an inpatient rehabilitation population, and it's pretty good for showing the types of changes that occur over a few weeks in inpatient rehabilitation. When we apply the FIM to very severe patients with very severe brain injuries soon after rehab admission, a pretty large proportion of them get the lowest possible score. But they're not all identical. They are quite varied, but they just are all below the bottom of this particular measurement tool. Even those very impaired patients, if we follow them out to 1 year, a pretty large proportion of them all get the highest possible FIM score. But they're not all the same. They're not all back at work. They're not all emotionally well adjusted. So we have this measurement tool that lumps people together in the beginning and lumps people together at the end and really only differentiates them and spreads them apart during the middle phase. And we need a single yardstick that can distinguish among people all the way from the earliest to the latest point. This particular study is one of the module projects. That's a term that comes from the Traumatic Brain Injury Model System, which is funded by NIDLR, the National Institute on Disability, Independent Living, and Rehabilitation Research. We hope when this study is done that we will have a proposed set of items that can measure this longer span of recovery. I suspect since this study will have only been done on probably somewhere under 250 subjects, that people won't be ready to just go out and use that tool in large, important studies as the next step. I think probably we'll need to do a study similar to this one, but with a larger and more heterogeneous set of patients, just to prove that the measurement technique itself is solid and precise. But once we're able to adequately show that the tool measures what it's supposed to measure, then I would expect to see people start to adopt it in various kinds of clinical trials or observational recovery studies. Physiatrists who are looking at treatments to consider for their patients, of course, need to be able to compare different treatments that are studied in different randomized trials and other kinds of studies. So I think since physicians are frequently involved in trying to review literature and decide on the most effective treatments in order to prescribe them or to recommend them, having a measurement tool that can help with this task will be really important.